I was driving west on Santa Monica when I passed the cemetery. I'd been thinking for months about my own image, something I didn't ordinarily consider. We change only in degrees. There are fluctuations and sharpenings and hair dyes and new clothes, but the essence of our physicality remains. And yet the way we regard that physicality shifts wildly. This was the first time in my life I'd considered my reflection and maybe not liked it, or more accurately, had little interest in seeing it and having the opportunity not to like it. I began to think about our modern age, how often we are confronted with ourselves, our images online and in mirrors and in photos and on identification cards, how we curate that image, how it elates and disappoints us, how we lurk in bars and dark places to obscure it. The first few lines came to me in the car.
I'm hiding from mirrors. I'm frightened of sex.
I knew it was the start of something, but it wasn't until I got to Nashville, some 2,000 miles away from LA, that the song came to life.
In the dark, everything, it looks better. Whoa, Hollywood forever. Hollywood forever. In the dark, I'm alive, I'm a legend. Whoa, Hollywood forever. Hollywood forever. In the dark, everything, it looks better. Hollywood forever, Hollywood forever.